There's an unwritten rule to never, ever underestimate Kyokai. When it comes to Heishin Unit, no math logic will work on them. If you dare, you will only end up with miscalculation and the damage result will vary. The only math logic that does compute well is adding up the intensity and thrills that result to an exciting chapter. It was a full course of action that reminds me why these characters are captivating and always put a smile on my face. The last chapter sets up Kyokai to take the center stage against the Great Blaze on the left with a lot of stakes on the line. It developed greatly on how important it is for her and the unit to win the battle in order to overthrow Gyo-on and his grand scheme. Naturally, it is as important as taking his head off. This chapter made Kyokai the star and once again continues to remind the fans why she is truly amazing. Neglect would never be an option. This chapter was pretty intense with many bodies hitting the floors. Everyone was in hellfire. Endless cavalry with plenty of slaying and defending that keeps them at the utmost struggle state. It also brings out their best with the rookies finally sees what Heishin Unit is truly capable of. Sugen is just a badass and it's not because of his eye patch. The man can't go and when he is serious, he is essentially a player character in a Musou gameplay that can take out 15 men alone. It's a good outlook for Kanto to be motivated once he is settled down with the unit after this battle. It does a great segue to the main event player. Sugen is pretty amazing, and it has to do with his sparring section with Kyokai. That's when it hits Kanto that his comrades are nothing but beasts incarnated. It has been a while since we last see Kyokai doing her dance routine and this chapter nailed it. Those swift maneuvers are always pleasant to look at and the climax scene with her jumping over a group, slicing their head off is gorgeous as ever. It's so worth waiting for that moment alone. Kyokai was also playing smart and risky with her tactic to recover her breathing in an earlier state. At first I thought it was odd that she has to rest up earlier than usual, almost like Hara forgot the duration. Fortunately, this was her plan to recover earlier in order to fight for a longer period of time. The only risk is to place Bungen and others to protect her as she has to sit still, hoping no one to interrupt. Kyokai restated that this battle is crucial and they have to do whatever means necessary, including her resting earlier than usual. She has to be the one to carry the men to victory. If she falls or fails to kill many, they will lose this battle, even the war for that matter. That's a lot of stakes on her shoulders and that had me worry for the outcome. Not saying she was going to die, but the body count around her would be too much. The battle is one hell of a massacre sight to behold. Oha was briefly shown here, though it was only to say that the day is nearly at its end. That translates to the battle against Gyo-on and his men would have to be dealt with next time. Surprisingly, we do resume the combat with him and Shin, and it is hype as ever. That said, Shin was seriously winded out, and if anything, this is the battle that was already determined from the get-go. As amazing it is for Shin to stand against Gyo-on, the last chapter made it clear that Gyo-on is above his league. Shin looks like in a very rough shape that can't somehow keep it up, but the chance to win is slim to none. If anything, he is one lucky bastard for Hyrule to show up on time from the battlefield, which also gives a questionable sign to Gyo-on. It was worrisome for Shin practically speaks like an unconscious state. Thank God that Hyrule can read the writing on the wall that Shin shouldn't resume fighting. If he allows him to, he will probably die here as much as I hate to say it. Even so, Gyo-on was a bit puzzled on his men on the left, so one way or another, the day of fighting is over for them. Shin finally passes out even when speaking tough and asks for one more round. On the bright side, the battle will resume one day, so the hype continues to stay strong. I believe Shin will eventually get used to Glaive, perhaps not at full potential, but far better than what we have seen here. I can't wait for the next round between them. If this is not the end, consider it as a hell of a teaser. That all said, we definitely got a payoff from this day, and it was stunning. Truly a moment to remember from this fateful day. Before going any further, I have to comment on the artwork here, because it is simply great. It is solid with blood splattering and intense raw power display. One moment that was captivating is when Kanto was in missile field of corpses as he is standing, startled at the magnitude. It plays off deeply that a rookie now has seen the devastation of a battle, and it wasn't over then. When it comes to picture perfect, it was at the end that says it all. Kyokai standing around the corpses as she faces at Gyo-on is a stunning shot that even has him shocked. You can really feel the chills from the scene alone. This is a great conclusion to the overall theme of the battle, despite not ending on a determined victory. Since the clash, Gyo-on has made three miscalculations, one in which is of course Shin, being an instinctual fighter as well, which saw his plan ahead. The second is how Shin was able to improve on the go and keep up with his strikes without stopping so soon. Lastly, is underestimating the raw power of Hishin unit, with Kyokai represent perfectly, bloody, but still standing. That made this day so worth it, just to give him a reality check he deserved. He may have won the physical battle against Shin, but he lost the instinctual battle. This was one hell of an intense day for Hishin unit, and certainly one of the best battles so far of the arc. It was thrilling and riveting from start to finish. Kyokai and others were badass, Shin did a good job on holding on, and the priceless reaction of Gyo-on at the sight was well worth it. I don't know if Shin will be 100% the next time they encounter, but he deserves a good long rest. Same goes to Kyokai, because she is starving. I'm definitely starving for more greatness. Share your thoughts in the comment. What do you think we're going to focus next? Are we going to stay focused with the Hishin unit? Or are we going to shift to somewhere else? Maybe we're going to see what's going on with Yotongwa. Maybe we're going to see what's happening to Moten. I don't know. But I would not mind to shift focus on somewhere else. But if we stay in the same wing, I don't mind. Because this battle was intense and it could only get better from here. That's what Kingdom does best. It only gets better from here. And that will do it for the review. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you like this and want more of this, subscribe to my channel and my world will be yours to stay. Until next time, take care.